Mr. Goodland? Mr. Goodland.
Ah, Miss West. I'm sorry I couldn't meet you sooner. You said you wanted to speak to me alone.
Yes, sir. It's kind of spooky in here, isn't it?
You don't like orchids?
Oh, really? They're my favorite corsage.
Indeed. We said something on the phone about seeing Tony the other night.
Yes, sir. And since you're his relative and you've been so polite the couple of times we met, anyway, this detective came to call this afternoon.
Oh, rumpled raincoat, rumpled face?
That's him, a lieutenant. Of course, I didn't tell him everything about Tony and me, I mean. And some of it I didn't even think of until later.
Some of what, Miss West?
Well, I think that he thinks that maybe Tony's kidnapping wasn't a real kidnapping at all.
I beg your pardon?
Like maybe Tony did it himself to try to get some money out of his trust fund. And as a matter of fact, Tony did mention to me that he might be able to get me a new car pretty soon.
And you believed his usual drunken promises?
Not really, I guess.
Tell me more about Columbo's little theory. I suppose my nephew also murdered himself?
No, that was whoever helped Tony, I guess. And now that person has got all that ransom money, too.
That sounds quite absurd to me. But tell me, why did you come to me with all this nonsense?
Oh, but it's not maybe. Because I also remembered, well, a long time ago, oh gosh, over a year ago, Tony told me, well, see, on the radio, I heard that Tony was killed by a bullet from a .32 caliber gun.
Yes?
Well, a long time ago, like I said, Tony told me he had a .32 that he'd given away. And I remember now who he told me he gave it to.
And who was that, Miss West?
His wife. Well, don't you see how that fits? Well, maybe she and Tony planned the kidnapping together. I bet she never even got that threatening phone call she told the police about. So after the ransom was paid, she brought in her boyfriend and killed him. Tony, I mean, not the boyfriend. And so they split the ransom, and she gets the estate, and nobody's the wiser, except me.
And now me. But why me rather than the police?
Oh, I don't know. I always feel funny around policemen. And anyway, it's you who's in charge of Tony's trust, isn't it?
In conjunction with the bank, yes.
Well, the radio says there will be a reward for whoever gets that ransom money back. $30,000 reward. And I'm claiming it. I'm going to help put that woman in prison and get paid $30,000 for it, too.
I'm sure you will, my dear. And you're quite right about the police, especially that stupid lieutenant. Now, why don't you let me handle things for a while, hmm?
Oh, well, but you won't forget about me, will you?
Miss West, I'll never forget you. Now, you just run along while I make some phone calls. And when the time comes for you to give your information to the proper authorities, I'll be in touch.
Thank you.
sir. I came over as quickly as I could, as soon as I received your message.
Thank you, Sergeant. Thank you. I heard your sirens from quite a ways off. Now, I would appreciate it if you'd hand this gun to your ballistics experts. I rummaged around for quite some time this evening, and I finally found it in a wall safe in my bedroom.
I don't understand.
Well, you see, when I told your Lieutenant Columbo that I'd owned a .32 but hadn't seen it for several months, he immediately leapt to accusations that that possibly could be the gun that killed my nephew. Now, I resent that implication, Sergeant.
Well, sir, different officers do have their different methods. I must say, the lieutenant's investigatory procedures do differ somewhat from my own.
Well, that speaks very well for you, Sergeant Wilson.
Well, thank you very much.
Now, I've heard things which cast an entirely different light on my nephew's death. Things so incredible, I can hardly believe them. Let's go into the house, shall we? Now, I feel it my duty to tell these
things.
Just
one more thing. As I see.